In today's video, we are looking at how to access your Picc line. You may be needing to do a patency check or to administer medications. So we are going to go over the process for that right after this. Welcome back, my name is Tammy and this is NurseMinder, and on this channel we do everything nursing. So if you're new here, consider subscribing below so that you get the next video when it's released. Patency checks are required prior to infusing medications or infusions, or at least every 24 hours if they're not accessed. To help us remember the process, we use the acronym SAS. The first is a saline flush, followed by your medication admin, another saline flush, and then your sodium citrate. If you're not using sodium citrate, you might be using heparin, in which case we can use SASH. So if you remember, the first step is to do a saline flush. So we're just going to prepare our saline here. Now every time we access a Picc line, we need to actually cleanse it with an alcohol swab or chlorhexidine swab for at least 15 seconds. This is to help prevent the introduction of microbes into the bloodstream. Don't forget to use some friction and to really get around that entire hub there to make sure it is clean to prevent any contamination. We'll let this air dry. I'm getting my saline ready here. I'm just going to prepare my syringe by removing the air, and then to attach with a push and twisting motion. Now we want to unlock the line so that we can infuse our saline. We're first going to put in 2 mL of saline with a gentle pressure. After those 2 mL are in, we're actually going to pull back now and look for a flash of blood in our saline. And this is telling us that the line is patent, and there we have it. Now we can go ahead and infuse the remainder of our saline using a pulsing pressure. And in your last 1 mL, you want to be clamping off the lock. Now if it feels like you need to force this fluid, then you may have a positional line or a partially clotted line, and you'll want to stop the procedure and troubleshoot it. Now that I've disconnected my saline, I need to cleanse the line, or I need to cleanse the port again before I can attach my medication. So again, a 15 second scrub using an alcohol swab or a chlorhexidine swab, using friction to help remove any microbials or bacteria that are on the cap. We let this air dry and we prepare to secure our medication or our infusion line into the neutral cap with, again, a pushing and twisting motion. And now we're ready to start our infusion. Now don't forget to unclamp the line so that your infusion can go through. And of course, we don't want this line just hanging and dangling from the bed, so we're going to secure it to our patient's arm with a piece of tape. Okay, so now the infusion is complete. We're going to continue on with our acronym of SAS or SASH. We've completed the first two steps. We did a saline flush and we administered our medications. Now we're going to continue with a second saline flush and a sodium citrate to lock off the line. Now I'm going to combine this with a cap change. This is done every 96 hours after blood work is drawn or when it looks contaminated. Now if you're not needing to do a cap change at this time, simply go ahead and follow the process without the cap. So the supplies I need for this are my cap, my saline flush, and my sodium citrate or heparin, depends on what your facility is using to lock. I'm going to lock off my line now that the medication is completed or the infusion is done, and simply detach my line. The neutral connector is still connected to the Picc line at this moment. The next step is to prepare my cap. So we're just getting the saline ready and we're going to prime the cap prior to changing the cap. And this removes any air bubbles. So from sterile tip to sterile tip, I can attach the two and gently push forward my saline until it is primed. Can you guess what's happening next? If you said a 15 second scrub, you would be correct. But this time we're going to focus a little lower and we're going to actually cleanse off the area where the cap will detach from the catheter. Again, a good 15 second scrub here. Use some friction to get rid of any bacteria. Again, once that's done, we're going to let this air dry. While that's drying, I'm going to gather up my syringe that has the cap attached, remove the sterile blue end. Keeping this end sterile, I'm now going to use my thumb and index finger to remove the old cap and simply screw on the new cap. Now I can go ahead and instill this 10 cc's after unlocking my line. I do not need to look for blood flashback because I've already checked patency prior to my med admin. Simply administer using a pulsating pressure and lock off your cap in the last mil of fluid infusion. After detaching the saline syringe only, you are now left with the new cap. But there's still one more step. We need to lock the line to make sure it doesn't clot. So again, a 15 second scrub is needed here, even though we have just put on a brand new cap. So just in case you haven't heard it enough, every time we access, we need to clean to prevent contamination into the bloodstream. Because this PICC line is actually sitting in the superior vena cava just as it enters into your heart. So again, when this 15 second scrub is done, we're gonna let it air dry. And then we can get our sodium citrate or your heparin prepared. Removing the cap, keeping sterile to sterile, we will insert and turn, and we're ready to instill. Unlock your line, and you can start to infuse your sodium citrate or heparin, preparing to lock off that line in the last 1 mL of infusion. Remove your sodium citrate, and you are complete. And there you have it. You now have the steps to access your PICC line for safe medication infusion and patient safety checks. Until next time, make it a great day.